age of total war, there is a fundamental transformation in the relationship between politics and economics, between state power and economics. For the first time, the sophisticated economies that had grown up in the 18th and 19th century as a result of the Industrial Revolution are harnessed for state purposes. And both these books, both Wages of Destruction, which deals with the 1930s and 40s and the Nazi regime, and the Deluge, really are fundamentally concerned with the way in which states, nation states, and empires struggle to mobilize resources and the consequences of this, both for domestic politics and their international relations. And above all, in both books, the central theme is the question of what difference it makes that the center of economic power, and with it the center of military power, shifts over the course of the early 20th century to the United States. So we move from a European-centered world of the 19th century, a global economy framed above all by the British Empire, in which the European states are major actors, to a global economy centered fundamentally on the United States by the 1940s and 1950s, and how states around the world, Britain, the British Empire, France and its empire, Japan, Germany and Russia, respond to these shifting parameters of global economic power is the central question of both books. The sort of sources that I use in both cases are a mixture of, on the one hand, data, statistics, quantitative evidence that allows us to capture the extraordinary shift in the balance of productive power, the enormous increase in industrial production, the flows of money and labor and food around the global economy, on the one hand. And on the other hand, what I'm very preoccupied with is the question of historical agency, of individual statesmen, of key decision makers and groups of decision makers, and how they respond to these anonymous, impersonal, gigantic forces. So the wager of both books is to juxtapose quantitative evidence, statistics, the aggregates of global power with personal documents, with memoirs, with diary entries, with the meetings and cabinet discussions in which you can see individuals grappling and trying to make sense of the world and orientate themselves above all to some sense of the future and how the world will develop. So it's this juxtaposition of these two types of sources which is for me a really fundamental way of understanding modernity.